Alright, so the first thing we're doing here is creating a kick. Generally you want to do this in like quarter notes. It's pretty simple. I'm just stretching this out here using the highlight shift drag function. And generally when you add a snare, you like doing it on the off beats, so it kind of complements your kick. And notice this isn't a four-bar phrase, so by the fourth bar, you always want to do like something different generally, because it lets the listener know kind of what's going on. And then I just add a hat on every single offbeat on the quarter note. That's pretty simple. That's actually all the percussion I'm going to be doing for this song. It's pretty straightforward. This is why I'm creating four Nexus sounds here. Well, I guess only three now, I add one later. I'm going to be doing two bass sounds, one like kind of pre-made arpeggio sound, and then the melody, which is going to have a cool harmony to it. So this is pretty standard, I mean, it's nothing special. So now I'm changing the sound by, I'm renaming it. I'm going to, change the sound to probably, I think this is the arpeggio. I actually planned on, sidechaining my bass, but by the end of this video my computer actually started, like, crashing, so I ended up having to close that, so sorry about that, but it'll still be a good bass. I think I just have one of the pre-mades used for my bass line, although I like to do the octave thing. I don't know, it seems like everyone does it, but I still like it. So this is the arpeggio that you're hearing now. I think this is where I, this looks like a standard line, but this is going to be the bass line I was talking about. Kind of just, I think I used the fourth one on the library, so. That's a cool effect. So for the singles pattern, I'm actually just gonna do the standard octave thing, but I have this Tronic bass sound that I found. It's called Trance Bass 1 in the Nexus under the bass category. I kind of like it when you do the octave, the lower octave first, actually. Some people like the higher octave first. It really depends on the song, in my opinion. So that should add a cool effect. If you have a bass up, you should be able to hear that pretty nicely. Right here I'm actually assigning all these to patterns. I guess I already did that. So obviously going down the eight patterns here, you always want to keep them numerical so it's easy to understand what's going on. And if you have all of them mixed around, it can get really confusing. Looks like I'm starting to think about how I'm going to build my melody now. I mean, this only took me a few minutes. I just kind of went with it. And obviously I'm not using the playlist function at all, which is an absolute must for any, like, actual song, because that's where you can introduce automation clips that, like, where you vary the... You can vary all sorts of things. I mean, you start with volume, but then you can get into equalizers, different limiter effects, and most a lot of the advanced features, like if you want to change your level of sidechain, or I don't know, just implement different patterns over and over again instead of having to copy them in the pattern list. Because right now, as you can see, I have just eight different sounds, in my one pattern. But if I was to move that over to my playlist, this would only be one pattern. See, it says pattern one at the top. So now with my melody, I just added the harmony at the top. It'll sound pretty cool when I change it to Dutch Tyler, which I finally decided on. There's obviously some really cooler sounds out there, but obviously I'm just going with this pretty quick. I'm not that great with Fruity Loops yet, but I have been working at it for about a year, on and off. Obviously, I'm a college student, so I'm not exactly free all the time. Right here, I like this actually octave bit by sliding it down and just control down the whole pattern, or the sound, sorry. And I love the poly portmanteau. It's actually just the sound that, it's like a transitional effect, so like the sound takes longer depending on what fraction you put it at. So like if the fraction's higher, for example, 1/1, you'll hear like a perfect glissando, which is where you have the, like all of the notes basically between note A and note B. It's like, it's kind of annoying sounding actually the lower you go. So most sounds you want to stick with, like 1/32 or 1/64, depending on the speed of your song. Obviously this has been 140 beats per minute. So right now I'm trying to add a sound effect, and this is where it crashes, so thanks for watching, guys. That was my Fruity Loops Nexus tutorial in 7 minutes.